Hi, and welcome to this YouTube channel. In this video tutorial, I'm going to teach you how you can prepare your article for submission on Scholar One website and how to ensure a blinded review. If you are new to this channel, please kindly hit the subscribe button and as well as the notification icon so that you can receive more updates from this channel. Thank you. Now, this video tutorial will be done based on the assumption that you already have your topic, you have already written your paper, and you have identified a journal that you want to submit this article to for publication. And this journal in question is using the Scholar One platform for submission of articles. So that's it. How do you now prepare your article in a way that you can submit it to this journal? This is exactly what I'm going to show you. Now, let's first of all assume that this is the topic or the paper I have written, and I want to submit this paper to Scholar One. With this author's information in this paper, it's not going to be good. Most journals will reject it if you submit it like this. So what are you going to do? First of all, let's start by creating a folder. So we create a folder, come to right click, you right click to get this. So you come to folder and then just call it a name. Maybe let's say submit. Submit. Then copy this work, don't cut it, copy it, the work in question, to that folder you have just created. Copy it to this folder. I'm going to tell you the reason why you should copy and keep the original version of your work. It's always good to keep the original version of your work so that in case you format this your paper according to the journal's blueprint, you can always fall back to the original article to make certain corrections. So now this is what we've done. We need to make this paper in two files. This particular single file, we need to split it to two files, a title page and the main article. So what do? We open the document. We open the document, then we come to the file tab, you come to create a new document, then we copy the title of the work, the author's information, the abstract and keyword to the new document you have created, paste it. Now after pasting this, you have to save this document to that same folder you have created, submit. Now, after doing this, you change the title, just indicate it as title page so that you can identify it later. You okay it. Then you see, consider it title page with all the author's information. So you can close this now if you like. Then for the main file, what we have to do is we need to remove any information pertaining to the author. In this case, I have highlighted and cut the information out so that the author's name will no longer be there. Meanwhile, before then, take note of these names. You look at these names. We are going to check the manuscript, the body of the work, to ensure that anywhere these names are found, we will replace them with the word author. So for now, we remove them and then save. We scroll down the article quickly to see whether we can find any of those authors. So we scroll down. Now you can see this. This is one of the authors. So what do? We remove this name and replace it with the word author. Let me zoom in so that you can see properly. So you replace it, with the word auto. Then we check again, check down quickly. We'll go down and then we'll see that that name is no longer there. So here we will have to remove completely this article from the references. You know, you see that this is where the original article becomes very important, because having removed this name from the references, you may not know again later on whose name and which name you remove. So that's why the original article need to be kept, so that after your work has passed the review stage and has been accepted for publication, you can now use the old file to re-edit it and resubmit it for publication. So this one is for review. So you need to remove any auto-identifying information. So that is what we have done. So the first stage of this tutorial is off. So what we now need to do is, we need to ensure that we remove, anonymize this document. How do we anonymize it? We come to properties, details. You can see the last person that saved this work, look at the name, the authors of this work, can see this name. This name was already in that article that was removed. So people can see, get use this approach to know who one of the authors or who the author of the paper is. So to avoid this, we remove all of this information. So most journals advise you to remove. So how do we do that? Look at, we come to remove properties and personal information. So I would prefer you use the default, create a copy with all possible properties removed. Leave it that way and click OK. You can see that a new version of this work has been created with the additional term copy added to it. So we can delete the first one. We do the same for the title page, properties, details, and then we remove personal details, and then OK. So you can see the title page too has a new copy. So we can delete the former one as well. Then with this, we can just save it as title page. Save it as title page. Then we could save this one as main file or article, as the case may be. Now this has been done. The next thing we need to do is to locate the journal we want to send this work to. With this, we are done with the preparation of the article. So we now have to locate the journal we want to submit this article to, and then see how we can submit this article online. So let me connect my computer to the internet. So having done this, we launch our browser. Then again, you need to prepare a cover letter for your submission. In your cover letter, you need to state what you are submitting that paper for, and if it's for a special issue or for a regular submission, then you need to state that you declare that the work is an original work and all of that. So your cover letter needs to be prepared. I think I have a sample cover letter I can show to you. Okay, so now this is a cover letter. We may use this one for this example. So now let's assume the journal I have in mind is, say, Britannica Journal of Social Sciences, yes, this is what I have in mind. I want to submit my article to them. So search for them on Google, you can see on their website, so we click OK. You can see the cover letter. See, so good. Now we will locate. We assume you have read the about the author, or you have read about the instructions for the authors, and you are familiar with their formatting standards, and you have prepared articles accordingly. So now we look for a submission, regular issue. We need to submit online to Scholar One, so we click there. Different journals may have different interface, but for example, we'll use this. So I'm submitting to this journal. So it takes us to Scholar One website. Can see from here. So usually what you do is, if you are a new user, you need to create an account. You need to do or create an account. So you click on create an account. So once you click on that, usually a form of this nature will come out on almost all Scholar One website. Now in this form, you are to provide your information, your preface. Are you a doctor, a miss, a mister, a missus, prof, and all of that. You choose the one that suits you. Your first name. So in this case, I'm going to say Mr. Your first name. You can just say Steven, for instance. Steven. Your middle name could be Baron. Your whole name may be different. And your surname may be Etim. Good. Now, you see the ones that have REQ, they are very required. That means they are compulsory. The ones that don't have them, you can ignore them. So for that, I'm going to ignore this. So for the email, let me put an email address. Say, for instance, you put your own email address there and ensure that you have access to that email address so that by the time they send information, they should be able to reach you through that email you have provided. So you repeat the same email here. At this point, you need to try as much as possible to avoid copy and paste, because it may not work. So what you need to do is you retype the email address. Sorry for this. So retype the same email address again manually. Then let me zoom this again so that you see it properly. Oh, it's too much. Good. So you retype this session are not necessary. They are not compulsory. So we can skip them. Go to next. Now They want you to tell them your preferred name as it is in the publication. That is, if you like, you can put it. If you don't like, you can leave it. The institution you need to put, but it's not required. So let me say university, you put your institution here and allow it to bring results for you to pick, because they already have a list of almost all the universities that are accredited worldwide. So what happened? Sorry for that, I think it was an error. So we start all over again. Mr. Say Stephen Baron 18. Okay, so email address is right here. Then we skip this section. So institution, University of, for instance. So we choose this one. When you start your institution, the institution will come up. You pick it from their list. You can type your department here. Say Department of Educational Management. So you can put that. Then the address is required. Put in the address of your institution. In this case, I think I already have this here. So the country is already here. The state and province is not necessary. And the postal code, just I think 54. You put the postal code of that area that institution is located. So after that, you click on next. So now at this point, you choose your password, so that you can be using it to access the website. So you choose a password you can remember, that you cannot forget easily. So I've chosen my own, for instance. Then they say you should choose your area or specialty. At least two are required. So you scroll down to choose the area of your specialty. So we look down. So for instance, we look at education management, add this. Then maybe inside there we have education system, you can add this depending on your area. So you choose maybe teacher education, you add this. This area or specialty you are choosing is to also help them, for those in higher education, in case they have papers for review, they can contact them to you as well. So with this, you can finish. Okay, I didn't check something. Yeah, I need to check this. So finish. If you like, if it's your system, you can save the password so that when next you come, you can remember. So you log in. But if it's a shared computer, please don't save the password. Have it at the, just hold it in your head. So you can see that name here is ready for submission. So now that you have this, you see the home, you see the author. In this home, you will find the journal's information. But when you click on auto, you move towards submission now. So with this, you can start a new submission entirely. So you can click on start a new submission. And then, okay, begin submission, you click. Now, in this at this first step, I think there are about five steps or so you follow. Okay, seven steps. You choose the type of article you are submitting, whether it's a research article like a normal empirical paper, you choose regular article. If it's a short communication, if it's a review paper, invited review, and there, but most of the time you choose a regular article. Then at this point, what you need to do is that folder you created earlier on, you have to open it now. You need to open the document you are submitting so that you can make things easy. So, when you open the article, we need to provide the title, a running head, and the abstract. The abstract will tell you how many words, 250 maximum. And then, so let's go to the work. Now, this is we copy the title of the work. And paste it here. Then the running head can give it a short title. Since from the title we can say HRMTJPRS. You can stop it there. This is okay. This is enough. This title is short enough. And the running head. So the abstract, you also copy the abstract, remember, from the manuscript. How many words are here? This is already 196 words, so it's okay. And then you paste it. After pasting it, there's nothing else, so you save and continue. Then, in stage two, you will be required to upload your articles. Remember, I told you you should separate your work earlier on, which we have done. So the first file, they say it should be the main document. You can see it here. So we select the file. We go to locate that folder we created. So we come to our desktop. Look at the folder here, submit, title page, article. So we upload the article here. Article has been uploaded here. So the next file, we will choose a destination and we will call it supplemental, not for review. But in some journals, you may see a title page. So since there's no title page here, we say supplemental, not for review, supplemental file. So we come to the title page and upload that one. So I haven't selected these two. We have not uploaded them yet though. So this is where we now upload these two selected files. So we click on upload and you wait for a while. The two articles or files have been uploaded. You can now see them here. So here you can remove them if you are not comfortable or whatever. You just have uploaded them. So the next thing is to proceed to save and continue. Then at this point, they say attribute. to show food list. They want to know which area of this journal coverage is your paper. Remember, this work was on human resource management. So we will look for areas that this journal covers that are related to human resource management. And then we look for them. Okay, look at human resource management here. We select it and add. So this tells you that this article is within the scope of this journal. Okay, and then they say we should select at least 4 areas, the maximum of 8. So apart from human resource management, the other one talk about teachers' job effectiveness, which when we look at it again, let's go up where we have education. Good. And you can select education management, add that, then you can go down again. Teacher education is part of it for teacher effectiveness. Then the focus of this work is in social and secondary education. Just choose another area that you feel your paper has relationship to. So after that, you can now keywords are from your article. They are not necessary. We can skip them. To the next stage. Now, at this stage, you choose at this stage whether you are an author, you are not submitting it on behalf of your co-authors, or whether somebody had asked you to submit for them, depending on which case fits your situation. So you say you are an author, you're okay. So that takes you to the location where you put in your name and that of the other authors. So you are going to fill in all of this information and go next. So you go to the next, and then here you need to, at the next stage, you need to select reviewers. But it's not necessary, it's not a must. If you don't have a reviewer, no problem. And most often, suggesting reviewers does not mean the journal is going to make use of those reviewers. They may make use of them later, but not for your paper. So you save and continue. You read the instruction. At this point, you need to provide that cover letter I was telling you, and it's compulsory. You can see that red star. So that cover letter, you can copy and paste it here or upload it if you like. So if you have a letter, you can open it from Microsoft and copy and paste. Or you can upload the Microsoft Word version here. And then after doing that, you save. You can now come to this section and tell them the number of figures that are in your paper. That means at this point, you need to open your papers. The paper now to check. This paper have no figure. A figure is more like a diagram or a shape. There is no figure here. So you go back and say for figure, You say none. Then number of color figures, none. We don't have any figures, so none is color. Then how many tables are here? This one, there's a table, we count them. Tables. So you count your tables. One, two, three. There are three tables. So we can simply say three. Number of words. It's quite simple. Just highlight all. 3,749. You can see them here. 3,749. So we write 3,749. Then you need to confirm all of these things by checking the boxes. If you have any conflict of interest, you check. If you say yes to the conflict of interest, then you state it. If you don't have, you check and go your way. So if this article, based on the research that was funded entirely or partially, if you receive fund for the research, you will say yes. If you did not receive, you say no. So you take all of that. Are you willing to pay the journal's fee for color reproduction? If you want it, you say yes. And if you know the implication, if you don't want it, you say no, depending on the case. Has your manuscript been edited by a professional English language editor? If yes, make sure that you have uploaded certificate on step 6. So at this stage, if your work has been edited as such, you took the yes. If not, you say no. Even though, why do you think it is not required? If you think it's not required, you explain. Whether you yourself are an English language expert, that's why you don't need external person to talk. Or if some other person have revised it for you, whatever are your reasons, you put them there. Acknowledge already this, you talk, you acknowledge. After checking all of these terms and conditions, you proceed to the last stage, where you will review all what you have written